Well, despite citing no actual evidence, Republicans in the House are pressing ahead with their investigation of President Donald Trump for possible collusion with the state of Russia. David Brooks of the New York Times, who despises Trump and says so all the time, even he is getting suspicious of the whole enterprise. Here's what he said.
I'm actually getting more uncomfortable with this whole deal, thinking that maybe we're getting a little ahead of ourselves. And I'm bothered by the lack of emerging evidence about the underlying crime, that there was actually collusion or coordination between the Trump White House. I'm just afraid we're being swallowed up by the politics of scandal when there's less and less evidence that they actually colluded. And maybe that'll come out, but so far it hasn't, and it bothers me.
So what is this investigation about, and when, if ever, does it end? Congressman Trey Gowdy just took over as chairman of the House Oversight Committee. He also serves on the House Intelligence Committee, and he joins us tonight. Congressman, thanks a lot, Mr. Chairman. Thank you for joining us.
Yes, sir. I hope you're feeling better.
I feel vigorous.
Good.
But I have lost track of the point of all this. What is the point of this investigation, just to remind those of us who are following at home?
Well, Tucker, the hyper-focus on collusion is not Congress's fault. I would say folks in your line of work have been focused on collusion much more than certainly Republican members of the House. There are four things that we're looking at. Russian active measures, which a subset of that would be collusion. The U.S. response back in 2016, which has nothing to do with Trump. That's an Obama administration response. And then importantly, the leaks and the unmasking, which have everything to do with the reauthorization of certain surveillance programs. So there are four things that the House Intel Committee is looking at. One of those involves Russian active measures, and a subset of that would be collusion, not just between Mr. Trump and the Russians, but any American and the Russians. So the hyper-focus on collusion and conspiracy and coordination, it's not mine. I'm interested in all four tranches.
When will we know what happened? When will this wrap up, do you think?
When the last witness is interviewed, and that is a legitimate criticism. I was ready months ago. There are only six members of the House Intel Committee that are conducting the witness interviews. Only six, so it's not the whole committee. I was ready 2 months ago to start interviewing witnesses. We are slowly beginning to do that. We have another one tomorrow. Our goal is to have this done in a perfect world before Labor Day. We've interviewed everyone, because keep in mind, if we don't interview every witness, then some skeptics are going to say the one witness you did not interview is the one that has all the knowledge. So you have to interview everyone, and then at the end you can discuss what evidence exists or does not exist.
So you said a minute ago the press was keeping the idea of collusion at the forefront of the public consciousness, which is of course true. I think you've been responsible in your public statements on this. We've had members of the committee on this show who have openly suggested, certainly implied, that there was collusion. There's clearly a political agenda here, and I'm not flacking for the Trump administration. Obviously, the president's hurt himself with his grotesquely counterproductive tweeting on the subject. But as a factual matter, there is a political agenda here, an axe being ground by Democrats. And doesn't that kind of color the whole investigation and make it maybe less useful from the public's perspective?
Well, it certainly may. The congressional part, I think Robert Mueller has a long, distinguished career that is essentially apolitical. And I think that people are going to be able to have confidence in the outcome of that investigation. With respect to Congress, we have a tendency to politicize almost everything, Tucker, and you're exactly right. There are members of both the House and the Senate who talk about, here's my favorite, I've seen evidence that's more than circumstantial but not direct, which, by the way, is tautological. There's no way it can be more than circumstantial but not direct. And then one of the members of the committee said this week that he has seen evidence. He can't tell us what it is. It's not beyond a reasonable doubt. There's no way to defend yourself against those kind of baseless, reckless accusations. So I think ultimately the public will have confidence in Robert Mueller's investigation. Whether or not they have confidence in Congress's investigation depends on how responsible we are and how we frame the issues.
So you've just taken over the chairmanship from Jason Chaffetz. How will the committee be different under you, under your leadership?
Well, there are two components to our committee, Tucker. There's oversight, and then there's government reform. Oversight is always in fashion. It's always in style because of branch equity and branch equilibrium issues. This is a once-in-a-generation opportunity to do the government reform that lots and lots of folks have been talking about for decades. So that's going to be my focus. It's going to be serious reform-minded ideas that save money. That, you know, what frustrates people is when we have hearings on waste, fraud, and abuse, and then we do nothing about it. So I look for fewer hearings on waste, fraud, and abuse, and more work on it.
I got to say, I love the hearings, but I'd also like to see some action. I'm sure lots of our viewers agree. Mr. Chairman, thank you for coming on tonight. I appreciate
it. Yes, sir. Thank you, Tucker.